In this class, we are going to discuss about SR latch by using NAND gates. In the last class, we discussed about the same latch, that means designing of SR latch by using NOR gate. So here in this class, we are going to design SR latch by using NAND gates. So as we know that NAND gates requires less power than NOR gates, we are going to prefer NAND gates for sequential circuit design throughout this sequential circuits topic. So now these latches also we can design by using NAND gates like this. The structure is same like NOR realization, but only difference is set input we are giving in normal port and reset input we are giving in complement port. So now our aim is to get required functionality, that means your latch need to get no change condition and your latch is to get reset and set conditions, and one condition you are getting as no change, indeterminate state also you are getting in this latch, particular latch. So I am going to define the truth table for this latch. So in the truth table, so what are the input variables and what may be the output variables means, definitely for any sequential circuit, the input variables are inputs and present state. That means our inputs are S and R, present state is Qn. So totally for a sequential circuit, we are having nearly three combination of inputs, that is inputs and present state. So here we are having complement, this is not next state. Everyone are going to confuse, this is your present state and this is next state. No, this is not next state, just a complement of present state. After processing these two, that means complement and normal present states, so present state and its complement, after processing whatever you are getting on the same ports, that is called as next state and its complement. So that's it. So now I'm going to consider my truth table for SR latch. So here definitely my three inputs may be S, R and Qn, and Qn plus 1 may be my output. So these are my three inputs and one output. This is my truth table for SR latch. So we don't know what state that is in already. So we don't know the present state of latch. We just know what inputs we need to give. That means we are giving some combinations for SR, that's it. We can give like that only. But we can't define the, we can't give the present state. That means that's already outputted value. We don't, we can't change whatever effect is there by that present state that the circuit is going to take. So, but in this case, we don't know this present state. Present state may be either 0 or 1, but we need to take that effect into the truth table. So I am just taking the input values 00, 01 and 10 and 11. These are the input combinations we can give for this SR latch. We don't know this state value, present state value we don't know. So this I am taking as present state and this is called as next state. So here we don't know the present state value, but we need to consider that present state as input. So here I am taking this first condition, when we given SR equal to 00, then what may be its next state, we are after processing this Qn to inside. So after processing this Qn to inside, whatever we are getting is Qn plus 1. So in the same way, after processing like this, you are getting next state complement. After processing present state and its complement, you are getting next state and its complement. That's it. So by either way, you need to see for a value in normal port. Otherwise, you can write your whatever you are getting. So you need to write there. So I am just checking the conditions. So that is equivalent to S equal to 0, R equal to 0. So S equal to 0, R equal to 0 condition. I am just checking here. So when S equal to 0, R equal to 0, so you can observe here. So I am just, every time you need to write for Qn plus 1. That means your aim is to get next state only. By taking the input of present input and present state, you need to get next state. In flip-flops or latches, this is the way. So if you want to take Qn plus 1, then what it's taking? So Qn plus 1 is going to take 0 into Qn bar whole bar. So that is your next state value, 0 into Qn bar whole bar. So here 0 into anything is 0, 0 bar is equivalent to 1. But you can observe complement of next state, that means if you want Qn bar, Qn plus 1 bar, then you need to get this gate output after crossing these present states. So here I am getting R into, that means 0 into, the input for this is Qn, so Qn whole bar. So here also 0 into anything you are getting 0. So 0 bar means 1 you are getting. Here you can observe next state and its complement are getting same value. So can we get like this, any variable and its complement having same value means that is meaningless, we can't get practically. So that means this state is called as indeterminate state, we can't determine this state. Like this we are getting means we can't determine either that is set or reset or no change, we can't determine the state, that state is going to waste, we are not going to take that state for operation of SR latch. So we are taking second one, that is S equal to 0, R is equal to 1 case, this is our second case. So S equal to 0, in R plus we are taking 1. Now every time if you are getting Qn plus 1 value, every time you need to check for Qn plus 1 only. So then if the inputs are like this, then with the reference of this present state, what will be your next state you need to check. So Qn plus 1 is equivalent to, so Qn plus 1 is equivalent to 0 into Qn bar whole bar. So 0 into Qn bar whole bar. So 0 into anything 0, 0 bar is equivalent to 1. I got 1 as next state. Here no need to take complement of next state. You know if Qn plus 1 is equal to 1, obviously Qn plus 1 whole bar equivalent to 0. That means this is equivalent to 0. No need to take once again for this. If you want to take, you can. If you got value in a normal port, no need to consider complement port, because we know that value by taking the reference of this. So I am just placing this value when S equal to 0, R equal to 1. So we don't know this present state, but we taken the reference in operation. So you got your next state as 1. So this is called as set condition. This is called as set condition. So in 1, 0, for example, your third case is S equal to 1 and R equal to 0. This is your third case. So S equal to 1 and R equal to 0. If you are giving S equal to 1 and R equal to 0, what is going to happen? Now, in this case, I am depending upon this complement state. You can take example here. So for example, if I define this state, I am not going to consider any value. I am not going to get any value in normal port. You can see, for example, if you are taking Qn plus 1, so how you are getting that Qn plus 1? So here S into Qn bar, that means 1 into Qn bar whole bar. So you are getting 1 into Qn bar means Qn bar whole bar means you are getting Qn. You are not getting any value for Qn plus 1. So you are just getting Qn, that Qn you don't know. So to get any value, that means you need to check, like this type of cases, you need to check complement port also. If you are getting value in complement port, then you can write complement here. So here I am just checking my complement for any value, Qn plus 1 whole bar. So then, so R into 0 into, so another input is Qn, so Qn whole bar, that is equal to 0 into anything whole bar means 0 bar means 1. Yes, I got value for complementary port. So that means by taking this reference, if Qn plus 1 whole bar equivalent to 1, we can write this Qn value as 0. So why? Because so Qn plus 1 bar you got as 1 means this 1 you are taking here. So you are getting 0 only. So here by taking this reference, I am taking this value as 0. So like this is reference is possible, we need to check the complement port. So by that complement port reference, you are writing your Qn value as 0. So this is called as a reset condition of SR latch. So finally, you are in your fourth case, that case is S equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. In this case, if S is equal to 1, what is going to happen? So I am checking normal port for next state. So here S equal to 1 means 1 into Qn bar whole bar. Qn bar whole bar. Here you are getting 1 into Qn bar. Qn bar whole bar means Qn you are getting. Here also like this, you didn't got any value. That means 0 or 1 you didn't got. Then you need to check for complementary port. Qn plus 1 whole bar is equivalent to you are getting. So here this is the condition of S equal to 1, R equal to 1, right? So R equal to 1 means 1 into, so another input is Qn whole bar. So here you are getting Qn bar. Here also you are not getting any value. So that means, so whatever Qn plus 1 is there, you are getting same Qn. Whatever Qn plus 1 bar is equal to there, you are getting same Qn bar. That means whatever present states are there, same present states are continued to next state. This is the meaning of this case. So we can write here as Qn. So I am going to write whatever Qn plus 1 is equal to Qn is there, that Qn I am writing, because I am writing for Qn plus 1. So this is called as no change state. No change state. So the meaning of this truth table is, if you are having SR latch with NAND gates, to reset I am taking 1-0 condition, for set I am taking 0-1 condition. So for no change states I am taking 1-1 condition, and this state we are not going to use because we are getting indeterminate output. So like this we are going to use this SR latch with NAND gates. So you can observe in NOR gates case, in 0-1 condition you are going to reset, and like that you are getting. So this is SR latch with NAND gates.